Greetings and shalom. Welcome. I am Alonso. Before I get started on our main focus, I'd like to mention that, you know, there's some movement going out there. Let's support these brothers and sisters any way possible. Let's serve each other. Agaza 8 or Tobia Teferi, you know, initiated some investment opportunities with the whole Mortar Club of America. Excuse me if that's not the exact title of the opportunity, but check out his YouTube channel page, Agaza 8, and get informed, you know, if possible, if willing, all seem well, you know, but make an investment towards I and I future. Now, Emerald Records, Tewahedo 1000, brother and company have initiated good sound, good music, you know, that would be pertaining the music and the musical aspect of the establishment of our kingdom, you know. Check that out on also YouTube channel pages, Emerald Record, Emerald Incorporated, and Tewahedo 1000. Highly recommend that music, but you know, overall, it's to support one another. It's to support one another, and you know, go about proceed in establishing the kingdom. You know, establish permanent residence upon this earth. You know, the dominion of Ainai, God and Father, Kedamawi, Haile Selassie, and His Christ. You know, Yehoshua, Yeshua HaMashiach. You know, Jesus Christos even. And so, continuing Facebook, regarding Facebook, you know, if you've not yet visited, go and visit EthiopianWorld.net on Facebook. There's a couple of other pages, but I highly recommend, first and foremost, EthiopianWorld.net, being that it has the actual teachings of Wendem Yadon, and so check that out. But don't forget the Lion of Judah Society and the Rastafari Fellowship also on Facebook. I mentioned that because some of the charts that are going to be I guess come from this information will be posted on those pages until I and I find another way to distribute to the LOJ Society. But you know, this information is going to be extremely important, so keep that in mind. Go check it out. It won't be posted this week for probably. So today is today is like Wednesday, August 22nd. I'm not sure if it's Wednesday, but yeah, August 22nd. And so, you know, give it 3 days, I guess. But who knows? They may be up tonight. So okay, continuing. As far as Rastafari Fellowship, this is, I guess it's not an issue, but you know, just for clarification purposes, if anyone happens to be discouraged because of the title, well, I and I is about to make mention that the whole purpose of Rastafari Fellowship is to support the Lion of Judah Society. So let the title not be a stumbling block upon some of the brothers and sisters. The main reason this channel page is even up is to support the Lion, to do whatever little I and I can to support the Lion of Judah Society. So it's not a entity of itself. It you know, it's never meant to become anything of itself. Not that it has, not that it will. But just to lay the initial intentions and, you know, the everlasting intentions of Rastafari Fellowship, you know, just to support those who proclaim the truth and declare the truth of His Majesty and His Christ, you know. So let the title not be a stumbling block. So now let us get into this. This is I know before we begin, I have to warn everybody. I have to give everyone a fair warning that this video might be slow, the information might be mixed and kind of like not that well organized. I myself am putting this information out there before it is 100%, before it's even 100% accurate, because I want to put it out there so that everyone that gets to come across this information can rebuke anything that is wrong, can make known any suggestions, can can declare corrections and mistake, point out mistakes, and so that's the reason. So I'm gonna learn along with all those viewing, but yeah, it's so important that I need everyone to really point out the mistakes, because this pertains to it's like our calendar, we could say, in a way, or at least our celestial, heavenly calendar. And so this needs to be as accurate as possible in order for it to work. And so I'm putting it out there, letting all know ahead of time that I don't know how this is going to go about, but I expect to review this video and learn from it, and then make some clarifications and see where more information could be, can shine some light on, some areas here. And, I'd ask everyone to comment on what they didn't understand, what needs to be explained, what I did wrong, how I couldn't explain some things, what some of you know. So let's get into it. Okay, we're gonna be dealing with astrology and the heavens, the constellations, and all that. I guess I have to clarify that don't be discouraged. I and I, Rastafari, are not to worship stars and stuff like that. That's the secularum, that's the worldly view. This, in fact, everybody's got their horoscopes, whatever they want to call them, zoology. But that's them being ignorant and wicked. Some wicked, some out of ignorance. But remember that this is, Beta Israel. This is the house of Israel. And, I and I Godfather. So I and I Godfather is the ruler of this house. So let us not be discouraged by what others have so wrongfully done with, our father's house. Let us set our house in order. I guess this would be part of our economy, the tribes are scattered throughout the four corners of the world, and hopefully this will put them, establish them back in their place, His Majesty clearly said that I will be replaced by the oncoming generation. Let us proceed to replace His Majesty and put him in his proper place. Let's set his house in order. So do not be discouraged. We're not going to be worshiping stars. As a matter of fact, the God of Israel is a God of holiness. So don't fall victim to the wrong assumption that because you're born in a certain month that the stars somehow limit you to only... I guess achieve certain amount such amount in your life, like don't let stars dictate your lives. That is not what this is about. As a matter of fact, it's the complete opposite. This is preparation for things to come. As a matter of fact, perfect timing, because if things are to come and you don't know this, life will become very difficult. This is just charity and mercy and kindness, how we can foresee things to come and prepare and not be overcome, rather overcome, be overcomers, pass on to higher heights. Let us continue, first I'm going to explain a little detail that might avoid confusion. So this line right here would be the equator, the Earth's equator, or even the celestial equator. And so this would be Earth. Yeah, I guess pretend that's wrong. That's Earth. What we're going to be discussing and learning on is going to involve the sine wave, which is the flow of life, the impulse, inhaling, exhaling, the waves of time, the waves of time and space. And so that is this, that is basically the sine wave, the path of the sun, that the path throughout the day, throughout the year, and throughout the solar year. And so, you know, you can even, sorry, like the serpent and all that, yeah, that's just symbology, but the main importance is what this signifies. So, okay, the reason I'm going to include this is because, in fact, we are going to work on it like this, round. And I don't want to confuse anyone. I don't want anyone to think that how come we're doing it like a circle, and in reality, the sine wave is kind of like, because this is March. This would be March 21st, this point right here. When the sun passes over the equator, not a solstice, but an equinox, you know, passing over the equinox. And so this is, my bad, this right here in the center is September 21st, and it's a kind of like passing under, but it's also the sun going over the equinox, the equator, you know, even the heavenly equator. So this would be March and then September, and this would be, my bad, give it just 1 second. See, this would be March all the way, this would be March again. And so I don't want to confuse people that, why is it a circle? Because we're going to work on it as in just planet Earth, right? But the actual sine wave goes like this. Man, I think we're off to a not that great start, because I think by showing this, I may have confused things. But let us continue, so you can understand a little bit more of what's going on. This right here, if you can recall maps, this would be the Tropic of Capricorn, basically. And then this up here would be the Tropic of Cancer. And what's going on is that, like, when the sun is up here, it's in the highest place, it's in the highest it'll ever go on its path, and you know, it lands on the Tropic of Cancer, on the constellation of Cancer, and it's the highest degrees that it will ever be from the equator, north of the equator, on the northern hemisphere, and it would be 23.5 degrees, and then it starts coming down. So what you have, this exaltation is spring, and then it hits the constellation of Cancer, and then you have summer, and then this is the September 21st, the autumn equal, what do you call it, autumnal equinox, or you know, it passes on to the fall. And so this would be fall, and then it hits the lowest degrees, the farthest it'll ever fall from the equator, and this would be it lands on the constellation of Capricorn, and it's 23.5 degrees south of the hemisphere, and then it starts going back up, and this is winter. So it's spring, summer, fall, and winter, and then it starts again. And that's where I don't want to get confusion. You see, this is a different view, but what we're going to be doing after this is the same. It's the same principle, just a little bit visually, it'll be just a little bit different. It'll seem different, but in reality, it's the same. And so now let us, I hope I didn't confuse you, but let us continue. Now we're gonna deal with what we're gonna be using as a chart and as a, I don't want to say calendar, but kind of like a map of the stars and so on and so forth. So let us begin by, you know, the cross, you know, the cross. So let us begin by establishing that's horrible. Okay, forgive I. That's the equator. Okay, so there we go. Let us begin by establishing the dates. This would be March 21st. This would be June 21st. This would be September 21st, and this would be December. You see, now I could explain it a little better. So here the sun is coming up. It's exalting itself, the exaltation of the sun. So this is spring. It's springing up, like jumping up. And then it hits the highest degree it'll ever go, 23.5 degrees north of the hemisphere. And this is the constellation of Cancer. Then it's gonna decline again, and this would be summer. And it's gonna pass over the hemisphere on September 21st, and that's gonna commence the fall, and this would be the fall. And then December 21st, it's winter, and it's gonna proceed to come up once more, and then the same pattern. So kind of like it's the sine wave, it's the flow of life, but from a different perspective. Now let us establish the, well, before we do, I'm gonna just mention that these points right here are the cardinals, are four cardinal points, and what these are gates and openings and doors and closings, you know. So like in Revelation chapter 4, when and a door opened in heaven, that means that they're directly referencing one of these cardinal points, because these are doors, you know. Passing over these points on our chart here signify a change, a opening to, like, for instance, from winter it hits March 21st, and that's it opens the door for spring, for the leaping, for the exaltation of the sun. And so I'd like to continue by giving an example of the next. Ayanda is going to discuss the what would be known as the fixed points. You know, these might have been I guess wrong, but we're going to go ahead and do it right on the graph over there. But just to give you an idea, so these are the cardinal points. These would be the cardinal points, and the fixed points that will never move would be, for instance, Leo, and these are going to be quartered, like the quarters of each season. So even like in the book of Revelations chapter 4, well, this is exactly, that's what it is. In the four corners, the quarters, you know, and the cardinal points are actually the crossing points. And so we have Leo, Mateus, and then we have Lucas, the water bearer, and then Aquila, which is also the scorpion, Johannes, and then Marcos with Taurus. And so just to get an idea of, and so you can see His Majesty, you know, because this is Beta Israel, this is the house of our fathers. And so we gotta manage our household and you know, and relocate and replace, reestablish the tribes of Israel where they need to be, you know, because at this point they're scattered throughout the four corners. Okay, and so since the four corners are fixed, they're gonna give us direction. So let this be east, let this be south, let this be west, and let this be north. Okay, continuing. I might as well throw this out there that this is reflective of the covenant. This is, in fact, the Ark of the Covenant, at least partially significant or symbology of a type of the Ark of the Covenant. And so let us go into that, might as well. Long ago, well, you know, earlier this year and during the Sabbath studies, there's videos out there. It's the I Am, or it was the portion of Exodus, the Bible studies of Exodus, and I was you know, the Spirit just put in I my mind this image, this picture, and it's on the videos. Really, I'd recommend, you know, I can't explain stuff all that well, but I'd recommend the many to actually watch the videos, because Jahs been gracious enough to to I've been Jahs been gracious enough to show me important information, and that I've been able to receive some of that. And so not all of it, right? But some of what I've received, it's not that. It's no, you know, it's nothing other than the fact that it's good information. If I did a horrible job in presenting it, then, you know, that's my mistake. But I'm new at this, and so, you know, don't let that be I may be boring and stuff like that, but, you know, don't let that be a stumbling block. At least check out the information, and 'cause, it was probably I don't know, whenever we do the study of Exodus, that would be March, would be numbers, kind of like in the beginning of the year, right? And so, well, actually, I think it's around here or something, the coming out. But okay, continuing, you know, that picture that was in my head is exactly what it's trying to be described when the Ark of the Covenant says, face to face, and that the angels were face to face, and that they spread their wings, and these are the wings, you know, and let us go into the faith, then into the rest of it. Watch. I mean, excuse the drawing. It's not to be beautiful or anything, but it's strictly educational. So, yes, okay, pretend. Well, that kind of looks like a person. It's the same deal going on. The sun, the path of the sun, it goes through our bodies every day. It descended from the head to the feet in the River Jordan, the descending, you know, the flowing, the descending flow. And the washing of the feet, getting prepared to pass over and meet, you know, meet the authority in the ras, in the head, in the beginning. And you know, the hands, the throat, the hands, the lungs, and then the lion heart, the heart of the lion. And then so the lion would be like that equilibrium, and then everything south are the lower chakras, the lower energies. And then so we have the stomach, the digestive system, and then we have the kidneys, and so on and so forth. So that is exactly what is going on. And let us just okay, let I regroup for just 1 second, and okay, let us just continue with this. See what happens. What should we go over now? So some might think, what does this have to do with the tribes of Israel? Well, the tribes of Israel pertain to each. There's three tribes within each quarter. And now that we touch on that, I'd like to make mention the 120. Uh, Leo, the tribe of Judah, is 120 degrees. Each degree is one day. So this would be zero. 90 degrees, 90 days, 3 months to get from the 21st of March to June 21st. And then another 30 days is 120 days, 120 degrees. Now, what does that have to do with the spirit only dwelling with man 120 days? Well, here's why. It's not that Jah dies, but what happens is, since the sun is in the constellation, in the house of Judah, Judah is not visible. So the sun is up here. You know? That's what's going on. It's not that Judah is no longer with I and I. It's that the sun is obviously there. In midsummer, and so, Judah's not visible. That's what's going on. So no, it doesn't mean that he died. I know of a truth that Yehoshua HaMashiach, even Kedemawi Haile Shilasi, do not die. Give me 1 second, please. Okay, there seems to be some activity in the skies. Shalom, forgive that. We'll get right back to this. Give thanks. Jah guide and protect all and die.